It hasn't started yet. Right now, you're seeing the flying. There's still some in the clusters. They're puddling down in the ravine here. And but soon, and maybe it, last year was the third week in 2012, it was the third week in January that we actually saw mating starting. So with that, we need to identify male and female butterflies. So here from this picture, you can see the male butterfly has two small dots on the lower wings. The female above does not. So the female, the male actually releases scent, and it will to the female, and it will connect end to end with the female. They can mate up to an hour and a half. They can mate multiple times with different butterflies. This one, they can fly while they're mating. And a female butterfly can hold up to, in the wild, up to 300 to 400 eggs. So when the butterfly has decided, the female butterfly, that it is time to lay eggs, they will leave the grove probably sometime. We say they leave by February 15th, but it all depends on, you know, when that's going to happen. So when they leave, they will not come back, and then the male's population increases greatly, and then they say, there's no more females, I'm leaving too. So usually by March 15th, they'll be gone completely. So, and then they will come back, hopefully the end of October and the first part of November. So that is the process. So here is a female butterfly laying an egg underneath a leaf, and here's the egg, just like I showed you, right down there. This year, pardon me?
She lays the eggs one by one.
Theoretically, one egg on each plant, but sometimes that's not the way it happens. They eat a lot, so it takes 25 leaves about this size for one caterpillar. So for any of you that have milkweed, you're going, oh my gosh, they just eat everything. Milkweed is toxic, so once a caterpillar eats it, it's toxic too. So usually a bird will only consume one in its lifetime because they immediately regurgitate it. So that's part of their defense mechanism.